In this video, we will learn the application of fundamental theorem of arithmetic. Let us take an example. Find the LCM and HCF of 510 and 92 by prime factorization method. Verify the LCM into HCF is equal to product of two numbers. So in the working column, we will find the LCM of 510. On dividing it by the smallest prime number 2, we get 2, 5, 5. Now, 255 cannot be divided by 2, but if you look at the sum of the digits, that is 2 plus 5 plus 5, it is 12. So it can be divided by 3. So on dividing it by 3, we get 85. Now 85, the total of 8 and 5 is 13. 13 cannot be divided by 3. Therefore, we will divide it by 5 because the last digit of 85 is 5, which can be divisible by 5. So on dividing 85 by 5, we get 17. Now 17 is a prime number. If you divide 17 by 17, we get 1. Thus, the prime factors of 510 are 2, 3, 5, 17, and 1. Now let us find the prime factors of 92. So the prime factors of 92 are, divide by 2, we get 46. Then dividing 46 by 2, we get 23. Now 23 is a prime number, so it will be divided by itself. So 23 divided by 23 will give you 1. Thus, the prime factors of 92 are 2, 2, 23, and 1. So now, let us write the prime factors in the solution part. So the prime factors of 510 equals 1 into 2 into 3 into 5 into 17. And the prime factors of 92 are 1 into 2 square, because 2 is present 2 times, into 23. Now, if you look at all the prime factors of both the numbers, so the factors are, so here we'll make a list of the factors. The factors are 1, 2, 3, 5, 17, and 23. Now let us write the LCM. In LCM, we take the factors which are present maximum times. So let us check which factors are present maximum times. So first we will take 1. 1 is present one time in both the factors. So the maximum presence of 1 is 1 time. Therefore, we will write 1 in the LCM part. Then, now think of 2. So 2 is present 1 times in 510 and 2 times in 92. Therefore, the maximum presence of 2 is 2 times in 92. Therefore, this factor is selected for the LCM. So 2 times 2 is selected. Then think of 3. 3 is present 1 time in 510 and it is absent in 92. Therefore, 1 time is taken in LCM. The next factor is 5. 5 is also present 1 time in 510 and absent in 92. Therefore, we take 1 time in LCM. Then the next factor, 17, is present 1 time in 510 and absent in 92. Therefore, the maximum presence is 1 time So therefore, we take 17 in LCM. And now the last factor, 23. 23 is present one time in 92 and absent in 510. Thus, the maximum presence is one time, which is taken in the LCM. Now, when you multiply 1 into 2 square into 3 into 5 into 17 into 23, we get 23,460. So, this is your LCM. Now, let us find HCF. For HCF, we need to select the factors which are present minimum times. So now let us think again of the same factors. So let us take 1. Now 1 is present one time in 510 as well as in 92. Therefore 1 is present minimum time 1 times. Therefore the minimum presence of 1 is 1 times. So we take it in the HCF part. Now let us think of the next factor 2. So 2 is present 1 times in 510 and 2 times in 92. That is, the minimum presence is 1 time. Therefore, we take 2 1 time in the HCF. Now let us take the next factor 3. 3 is present 1 time in 510 and it is absent in 92. Therefore, it will be absent in HCF. Then the next factor is 5. Same way, 5 is present one time in 510 and absent in 92. Therefore, it will be absent in HCF. Then the next factor 17, present one time in 510 and absent in 92. Therefore, absent in HCF. And the last factor 23, which is present one time in 92 and absent in 510, therefore it is absent in HCF. Thus, the HCF is 1 into 2, that is equal to 2. Now, let us go for the verification. So, for verification, we will multiply LCM into HCF, that is equal to 23,460 into 2, which gives 46,920. Now let us take the product of two numbers. The numbers are 510 and 92. On multiplying these numbers, we get 46,920. The product of LCM and the product of two numbers is equal. Therefore, LCM into HCF is equal to product of two numbers. So this has been verified. Thus we complete the second problem.